Brian Hilliard, the IRA has said or has made the claim that the police are incompetent. How much credence should we give that?
None at all. It's a long-standing IRA tactic to demonstrate to their followers that the police are incompetent. The tactic actually works with Mr. Churchill Coleman, who is constantly forced to come on television and give press interviews when it's known he can say nothing at all. But by his constant appearance makes it appear that the police are not doing anything, whereas all he's doing is answering necessary media questions about an incident.
Is there no attempt then to save human life, do you think?
I don't think the IRA have ever given a warning, and they do give some warnings, they've ever given a warning which has enabled police to save lives. When we think of the number of people who are being killed, you've got to think, well, in those cases, why didn't the IRA give warnings? In the last week, we've had, 40 nuisance bombs. One of them has killed a person, and there's very little warning, if any, about any of them.
When they do come, how difficult is it to tell between the hoaxes and the real coded warnings?
The difficulty lies at Scotland Yard. The warnings come usually to radio stations or to television stations. They're passed on to Scotland Yard. Scotland Yard know the code words or sets of code words. But even so, they know that probably one in three of the genuine calls are in fact only genuine. The other two are deliberate IRA hoax calls to confuse the later investigation.
Once the calls come in, though, could the police not act quicker?
I don't think police can act any quicker than they do already. A 20-minute gap between the warning and the action is about the best that police can do. 10 minutes is usually the warning that the IRA give. You about it, the police say, no, we didn't tell you about it. And in the end of the day, you've got perhaps 20,000 people along the North Circular Road who are upset and don't know who is winning the war. The IRA say, well, we told you about it. The police say, no, we didn't tell you about it. And in the end of the day, you've got perhaps 20,000 people along the North Circular Road who are upset and don't know who is winning the war.
Thank you very much indeed. Thank you.